Welcome to my channel. This time we discuss about the kingdom, ruler of the lands of Java from the 6th century to the present. Knowing past history will know our identity, what is good we use and what is bad we throw away. The history of our ancestors has taught us noble values and precious legacies, which of course are rarely preserved nowadays. Our country is very rich in both culture and technology. It's just a matter of how its children and grandchildren will continue and develop it. To find out who our ancestors were, let's take a look at the rulers in the land of Java who once filled their past days with joy and sorrow building a civilization. The titles used are Maharaja, Maharani, Subhasuna, Sultan and Duke. The form of kingdom, Kesunanan, Sultanate and Dukedom. Kingdom of Kalinga or Holing. The historical source of the Kalinga kingdom is Tuknas inscription. This inscription in Pali letters and Sanskrit was found on the western slope of Mount Merapi, in Lepak village, Rabat district, Machang Regency, central Java, to be precise. In it, there is praise for the springs that come out of rocky crevices like the Ganges River, the river in India. Sojo Murto inscription. The Sojo Murto inscription was found in Sojo Murto village, Rabat district, Machang Regency, central Java. Unlike the Tuknas inscription, this inscription uses Kahi letters and the language is Old Malay. The contents of this inscription is a story about the Dapanda Syasalendra family or dynasty. Dapanda Syasalendra is the forerunner of the kings descended from the Syasalendra dynasty. Chinese news from the Tang dynasty. In this Chinese news, it is mentioned about the existence of the Holing kingdom, which is located in Chosehot Java. The kingdom of Holing is another name for the kingdom of Kalinga. News from I Seng, the Buddhist priest from China. The Kalinga kingdom is a Hindu-style kingdom that began to develop around the 7th century AD. The rulers of the Holing kingdom are as follows: Wasumurti from 594 to 605, Wasujini from 605 to 632, Wasudewa from 632 to 652. King Wasudewa's reign coincided with world events, namely, after the Prophet Muhammad died in 632 AD, Muslim armies conquered most of the Middle East. They united a number of areas under the rule of a caliph. At its peak, the medieval Islamic world was more than three times the size of the entire Christian empire. Under the caliph, major cities such as Cairo, Baghdad, and Damascus fostered a vibrant intellectual and cultural life. Poets, scientists, and philosophers wrote thousands of books. Scholars translated Greek, Iranian, and Indian texts into Arabic. Inventors designed technologies such as the pinhole camera, soap, windmills, surgical instruments, early glyphs, and the number system we use today. Religious scholars and mystics translated, interpreted, and taught the Quran and other holy texts to people throughout the Middle East. Wasukahi in 652 until unknown. Kirata Singha from 632 to 648. Kartikeya Singha from 648 to 674. Queen Shima from 674 to 695. Queen Shima's title was Sri Maharani Mahisasura Mardini Sahiputi Keswara. Under Queen Shima's reign, the Kalinga kingdom reached its peak of glory after taking over the role of a trading port on the north coast, which was previously controlled by the Tarumanipura kingdom. Like the previous king, Queen Shima also maintains relations with China, which is done by sending her envoys. During her reign, Queen Shima was famous for her policies, which were very tough and firm, but also just and loved by her people. To keep his kingdom safe, he ensures that laws are enforced indiscriminately, so that no one dares to break the rules. The most famous rule is that anyone who steals will have their hands cut off. After Queen Shima died in 695, the Kalinga kingdom was conquered by the Sriwijaya kingdom. The royal territory was then divided into two, for her two children, namely Goddess Parvati in Yogyakarta and Narayana in Machang. Kingdom of North Kalinga or Kelling. Prakrayanarayana from 695 to 742. Prakrayanli was Singha from 742 to 760. Prakrayan Limritwana from 760 to 789. The Kingdom of South Kalinga or Ancient Medhang or Mataram. Goddess Parvati from 695 to 709. Goddess Senaha from 709 to 716. Prakrayan Sanjaya from 716 to 746 founded a new dynasty called the Sanjaya dynasty. The ancient Medhang or Mataram kingdom. The ancient Mataram kingdom is also known as the Hindu Mataram kingdom or the Medhang kingdom. The ancient Mataram kingdom existed in the 8th to 11th centuries and was ruled by three dynasties, namely the Sanjaya dynasty, the Syasalendra dynasty, and the Asyana dynasty. The ancient Mataram was first thought to have stood in Bumi Mataram, which is around Yogyakarta. Based on the period of his leadership, the location of the capital city was originally in central Java when the Sanjaya dynasty and Syasalendra dynasty were in power. During the leadership of the Sanjaya dynasty, the ancient Mataram kingdom with Hindu features had a strong influence. After being replaced by Rakhipanakaran, the split began to appear, which divided the leadership into two. The Sanjaya dynasty, which led the ancient Mataram kingdom with a Hindu style, ruled in northern central Java. Meanwhile, the Syasalendra dynasty and the ancient Mataram kingdom with Buddhist styles ruled in southern central Java. Under the rule of the Syasalendra dynasty, the ancient Mataram kingdom reached its peak of glory. During the leadership of Sri Dharmatanga, the territory extended to the Malacca Peninsula. His successor Syasalendra also succeeded in defeating Chetla in Cambodia. Not only power, but culture also developed, including building the Borobudur Temple during Samratanga's leadership. The two dynasties reunited through the marriage of Rakhipatan and Pramoda Wardhani. Meanwhile, during the reign of the Isyana dynasty, Imphusundok shifted the capital of the kingdom to East Java. There are several factors that are said to have influenced this move, including the eruption of Mount Merapi, power struggles, attacks by the Sriwijaya kingdom, to the absence of a port so that the economy was difficult to develop. Historical relics of the ancient Mataram kingdom, namely the Kangal inscription, Kalatan inscription, Balatong inscription, Klerup inscription, Gaitong Songo temple, Borobudur temple, Minduf temple, Platasan temple, Pravina temple. List of ancient Mataram kings. Rakhai Mataram, the Queen Sanjaya from 716 to 746. Prakhipanakaran Dayapankapana from 746 to 784. Prakhipanaraban from 784 to 803. Prakhiwarak Dimanra from 803 to 827. Dayagula from 827 to 829. Prakhigaran from 829 to 847. Prakhipikatan Dayasalaju from 847 to 855. Prakhigawati Dayalokapala from 855 to 885. Dayatagwas from 885 to 885. Prakhipanambagan Dayadevendra from 885 to 887. Prakhipanarunwati Dayadvadra from 887 to 887. Prakhipunkahumalang Dayajabang from 894 to 898. Prakhiwatukara Dayabalatong from 898 to 908. Dayadakso Atamath from 908 to 919. Prakhilayang Dayatibadong from 919 to 924. Prakhibankabja Dayavawa from 924 to 929. Imphusundok from 929 to 947. Isyana Tongva Wijaya from 947 to 985. Makuta Waxawart Anat from 985 to 990. Termawaxa from 990 to 1006. The Pukongan inscription tells of the destruction of the Medhang kingdom, known as Mahapralaya or the Great Death. It is said that Dharma Wagsatega married his daughter to a Japanese Balinese prince who was only 16 years old, named Erlangga. In the middle of the crowd, along with the royal family who were immersed in the luxury of the party, suddenly the palace was attacked by Hajiwaraweri's troops from Warum, the vassal of the Medang kingdom. The deadly flood-like attack completely submerged Medang in devastation, causing the Dharmawagsa palace located in the city of Watan to be burnt to the ground. Dharmawagsatega himself and all of the king's relatives died in the attack, while Erlangga, who was his son-in-law and nephew as well as Dharmawagsa's daughter, escaped death, accompanied by his maid Impu Narottama. The death of King Dharmawagsa and the destruction of the capital Watan under the pressure of the Warm rebels ended the Medang kingdom and plunged it into a state of chaos. Due to the absence of a supreme ruler, the warlords in every province, region and settlement in central and east Java rebelled, and broke away from the Medang central government to form an autonomous region or self-government. Then rampant robbery, riots, violence and further crimes took place a few years after Medang's fall to the detriment of the country's situation. 3 years later Erlangga appeared, with the support of the priests and the request of the people of Medang. He built a new palace at Watan Mass and founded a new kingdom, named Kotaripan. Kotaripan Kingdom. The kingdom with its center in Kotaripan has an area stretching from Pasuruan in the east to Mathoa and in the west. The north coast of Java, especially Sidoarjo, Surabaya and Tuban, became important trading centers for the first time. According to the Trunhutong inscription in 1044 AD, at the end of his reign in 1042, Erlangga was faced with the problem of competition for the throne between his two sons. The real king was Erlangga's daughter. The real name of the princess from the Kane inscription 1021 to the Pasarlaji inscription 1043 is Sangrama with Jayatanga Duai, who became the crown princess and heir to the throne of the Medang Kotaripan Palace, but she chose to resign and live a holy life as a recluse nun with the title goddess Kilisusi. Later in the same year, based on the Pawatan inscription 1042 and Sarat Kalan Arang, Erlangga moved his capital and founded the city of Dakhnapurit in the Panjalur Kagri region. Before abdicating, at the end of November 1042, on the advice of his royal advisor and teacher Impu Bharata, Erlangga was forced to divide his kingdom into two. The western part, namely the Panjalu region with the capital in Dahi, was given to Sri Samaruhaya. Then the eastern part, namely Jangala with the capital in Kotaripan, was given to Mahapanchara II, Jangala Kingdom. The rulers of the Jangala Kingdom are as follows: Mahapanchara II from 1042 to 1052, Galandu Hogyas from 1052 to 1059, Samaraha in 1059, Kingdom of Kayadiri or Panjalu. Rulers of the Kingdom of Kayadiri or Panjalu as follows: Samarwijaya in 1042, Jayatandiyarayakara in 1051, Jayawarsa in 1104, Bameswara from 1112 to 1135, Jayabhacharya 1135 to 1157, uniting Panjalu Kadri and Jangala, Sarwaiswara from 1159 to 1161, Ariswara from 1169 to 1171, Gondra from 1171 to 1180, Kameswara from 1180 to 1190, Kurtajaya from 1194 to 1222. Kurtajaya's reign coincided with world events, namely the Crusades began in 1095, when Pope Urban summoned Christian soldiers to fight their way to Jerusalem. The war continued until the end of the 15th century. Finally, Jayakatwa in 1292 to 1293. Kurtajaya was defeated by Kanarak from Tumapelra Singhasari, which marked the end of the Panjalu kingdom. Since 1222, Panjalu has been a subordinate area of Tumapel. In 1292, Jayakatwa rebelled and ended the history of Tumapel. Jayakatwa was the regent of Galang-Galang, now including the Madian region, who in 1292 rebelled and brought down the Singhasari kingdom to revive his ancestral kingdom, namely Kayadiri. but only lasted for a year before being destroyed by the combined forces of the Mongols and Majapahit. Singhasari Kingdom. The Singhasari Kingdom is a Hindu-Buddhist patterned kingdom originating from Malang, East Java. This kingdom was founded by Kanarak, who had the title Sri Rajasabhathra Sangharabhumi in 1222. The Singhasari Kingdom reached its heyday in 1272-1292 during the reign of Kirtanepura. Here are the kings who ruled Singhasari: Kanarak Sri Rangarajasabhathrabhumi from 1222-1227, Anasapati from 1227-1248, Dohachaya from 1249-1250, Wisnuwardhana from 1248-1268, Kirtanagara from 1268-1292. Kirtanagara was the figure of the first Japanese king who wanted to expand his power to cover the archipelago. Nagarakrita Bhama mentions Tumapel's subordinate areas outside Java during the Kirtanagara period, including the Malay kingdoms, Bali, Pohang, Marun, and Bhattulapurit. Kirtanagara's death in 1292 was caused by Jayakatwa's rebellion, the regent of Galangalang, who, according to the Mulamalarong inscription, was his cousin, brother-in-law, and was the reason for the collapse of the Singhasari kingdom. This resulted in the release of Singhasari's territory, including Bali, Marun, Pohang, and Tanjungpurit. Waxarajasa's government was then continued by his son-in-law, Ratan Wijaya, by establishing the Majapahit Kingdom in 1293. Majapahit Kingdom. The history of the founding of the Majapahit Kingdom began with Ratan Jayawijaya's request to Jayakatwak to open a forest in the Tarak area. Jayakatwak is the king of the kingdom of Galangalang. He was an influential figure in the downfall of the Singhasari Kingdom. Kirtanepura, the Singhasari leader who is also Ratan Jayawijaya's father-in-law, died as a result of the attack by the Galangalang soldiers sent by Jayakatwak. Singhasari Palace has also been occupied. This made Ratan Wijaya with his wife and a number of the remaining troops leave Singhasari to go to Madura. They wanted to meet at Adipati Wirajaya. Wirajaya advised Ratan Wijaya to surrender to Jayakatwak. It was Wirajaya who proposed to Ratan Wijaya to clear the forest in the Tarak area. Ratan Wijaya obeyed Wirajaya's words. While serving Jayakatwak, Ratan Wijaya proposed to open the Tarak forest as a hunting ground for King Jayakatwak. The forest was turned into a residence as well as a place to build strength. The place was then called Majapahit or Wiltikta. The origin of the name Majapahit is when the workers started clearing the Tarak forest, many Maha fruit wilt were found and they tasted bitter tikta when eaten. Ratan Wijaya and Wirajaya were finally able to build strength to invade Jayakatwak. Moreover, at that time, they heard the arrival of the Tartar army from the Mongols. The troops actually wanted to attack King Kirtanepura, who had been killed by Jayakatwang's soldiers. By Ratan Wijaya and Wirajaya, the Tartar troops were invited to work together. The combined forces finally succeeded in bringing down Jayakatwang. The kingdom of Galangalang collapsed. Ratan Wijaya then took over power and led the Java region from Majapahit. Before being appointed king of Majapahit, Ratan Wijaya first drove away the Tartar troops. The Majapahit Empire experienced a golden age when it was led by Hlambuluk. This grandson of Ratan Wijaya ruled from 1358 to 1389 AD. When he left, he was accompanied by Pandit Gajimata. The heyday of the Majapahit Kingdom was said to be inseparable from Gajimata's rule. He was appointed governor of Amankubhumi in 1336 AD or when Tribhuwana Tongaduai was in power. During his coronation, Gajimata vowed to unite the archipelago under the banner of Majapahit. The oath was called Amukadei Palapa, or known as the Palapa Oath. In that oath, Gajimata wished to rule over countries outside of Majapahit. These countries are Karun Lombok Srinsetam Tanjungpura Kalimantan Peru, North Sumatra Pahang Malayadam Ho, Bali, Sunda, Palembang Sriwijaya and Tumasik Singapore. Gajimata also fulfilled his oath. The territory of the Majapahit Kingdom became wider, even more than it had hoped for. The Majapa Empire controlled most of Sumatra, Kalimantan, the Malay Peninsula, and the eastern islands of Java. The countries controlled by Majapa are recorded in the Nagarajputra book chapters 13 and 14. The Majapa Empire, whose strength was so great, finally began to collapse. The collapse of the Majapa Empire occurred after the Hilambuwa era. One of the causes of the collapse of the Majapa kingdom was internal conflict. The collapse of the Majapa kingdom was caused by the Pereg-Reg War. The Pereg-Reg War involved two royal relatives, namely Bari Wirabumi and Wipunurbana. Wipunurbana is the ruler of the throne of the Majapa kingdom after Hilambuwa. He was made king in 1389. Wipunurbana is Hilambuwa's son-in-law and nephew. Bari Wirabumi, Hilambuwa's son from a concubine, opposed the appointment of Wipunurbana. During Wipunurbana's leadership, many areas in Majapahit's territory broke away without being able to be prevented. This was further exacerbated by the occurrence of a famine in 1426. The collapse of Majapahit was also influenced by the strengthening influence of the Ming dynasty and several areas that were formerly subordinate to the Majapahit kingdom. Among the Majapahit kings are Ravanwijaya from 1293 to 1309, Jayanagar from 1309 to 1328, Tribhuwana with Jaya Tongaduai from 1328 to 1350. Tribhuwana with Jaya Tongaduai's reign coincided with world events, namely a mysterious disease known as the Black Death. Bubonic plague occurred between 1347 and 1350. This plague killed around 20 million people in Europe, or about 30% of the continent's population. Hilambuwa from 1350 to 1389, Wipunurbana from 1390 to 1428, Suhita from 1429 to 1447. Suhita's reign coincided with world events in 1440. The German inventor, Johannes Gutenberg, introduced the printing press to Europe, revolutionizing literacy and acting as a catalyst for the spread of knowledge around the world. Then Kurtavijaya from 1447 to 1451. Rajasawardhana from 1451 to 1453. Rajasawardhana's reign coincided with world events, namely the fall of Constantinople in 1453 by Sultan Eymtuhba of the Ottomans, who was still 21 years old. Constantinople is a prominent city in the world and has been the capital of the Eastern Roman Empire for 16 centuries. Then Jarishawardhana from 1456 to 1466. Singhawikramawardhana from 1466 to 1474. Trendawardhana from 1474 to 1519. Trendawardhana is the title for the Majapa king Bari Kelling, or the ruler of Kelling. The rulers who used this title were Dayawijaya Karana, Dayawijaya Kusuma, Dayaratawijaya. According to the Paratratan book, they are descended from King Majapahit Singhawikramawardhana, who before becoming king had served as Bari Pandansalads and Bari Kelling. Rajasawardhana's eldest son, Dayasamrawijaya, identical with Bari Kagaripan, is told that after Rajasawardhana died, there was a struggle for the throne between Samrawijaya and his uncle Suryanawikrama, identical with Jarishawardhana. In 1456, Samrawijaya gave up the throne of Majapahit to Suryanawikrama, who was none other than his uncle and father-in-law. In 1466, Girisawardhana died and was succeeded by Suryaprakrama, his younger brother. This caused another power struggle with Rajasawardhana's children, so that in 1468, Rajasawardhana's youngest son, Bari Kurtabhumi, rebelled against Suryaprakrama. Dayasuryaprakrama was with his family, including Dayawijaya Karana, Dayawijaya Kusuma, and Dayaratawijaya, fled to the Kelling Kagri area and became the ruler of Kelling with the title Trendawardhana. After Bari Kurtabhumi was defeated, according to the Jidwai 1 inscription, it states that in 1474, Trendawardhana Dayaratawijaya became the king who ruled over Wiltiktapura. Another name for Majapahit is Jangala, and Kairi. The title of Drangarwar.ni is found in the Wetar Inpitu inscription dated 1369 Seka in 1447 AD, as well as the Tak inscription and the Jitwai inscription, which are both dated 1408 Seka in 1486 AD. Dutch experts such as Kromp, Stutterham, Schriek, and Zoetmulder thought that these kings formed a new dynasty in Majapahit, namely the Drangarwar.ni dynasty, and came from Kelengkateri. Among the common people, the kings of Drangarwar.ni are often associated with Brahmahatya, who is popular and only exists in Islamic Mataram Europe Japanese literary works and folklore. Sultanate of Demak. The Sultanate of Demak or Kingdom of Demak is a Japanese Islamic kingdom that was founded in the last quarter of the 15th century in Demak. Demak was previously a duchy subject to Majapahit, which had weakened by then for several years before breaking away. According to a popular Japanese traditional story, this kingdom was founded by Ratanpitit, son of the last Majapahit king. Demak played an important role in ending Majapahit rule and the spread of Islam in Java. Throughout the first half of the 16th century, Demak was at the peak of its glory under the reign of Trungganap. Here are the kings of Demak: Ratanpitit from 1475 to 1517, Padiyanyus from 1518 to 1520, Trungganap from 1521 to 1545, Chunakrautit from 1546 to 1547. After enjoying its golden age, the kingdom of Demak collapsed at the end of the 16th century. One of the causes of the collapse of the Demak kingdom was the civil war that occurred between Chunakrautit and Irapinhangsay. The Sultan of Demak, namely Sultan Trengono, died while on an expedition to expand his power. Based on historical records, Sultan Trengono died because he was killed while attacking Panarukan Situ Bondo in East Java, which was then controlled by Lambangan. After the death of Sultan Trengono, the kingdom of Demak experienced a power vacuum. This condition was then used by the eldest son of Sultan Trengono, namely Chunakrautit, to replace his father's position. Chunajiri and the elders of the kingdom of Demak agreed that Chunakrautit would ascend the throne as king in 1546. But unfortunately, during his reign, Chunakrautit was considered to be more busy working as a religious expert than the leader of the kingdom of Demak. As a result, the regions under the auspices of the Demak kingdom began to break away, which then had an impact on the kingdom's retreat. The aftermath of this event was the occurrence of civil war. Chunakrautit was involved in a war with his cousin, Birapinhangsay. Birapinhangsay is the son of Prince Sikersatalepan, who is the older brother of Sultan Trengono. When Chunakrautit became king, Birapinhangsay felt that he was far more fit to occupy power. Birapinhangsay's rejection of Chunakrautit's coronation was also driven by his feeling of revenge against his father's death. Birapinhangsay then took revenge by trying to seize the power of the Demak kingdom from Chunakrautit. The civil war in the kingdom of Demak lasted from 1546 to 1549. This civil war only ended after Birapinhangsay suffered defeat. The civil war that occurred between Chunakrautit and Birapinhangsay received criticism from Oko Tinkir Sultan Padiwijaya. Sultan Padiwijaya is the son-in-law of Sultan Trengono. Oko Tinkir, together with Kijit Feminate Agin and Kipanjoi, made a number of attempts to seize the power of the Demak kingdom from Birapinhangsay. In the end, Oko Tinkir, Kijit Feminate Agin, and Kipanjoi managed to defeat Birapinhangsay at Jipangpanoland. In 1568, Oko Tinkir ascended the throne as king of Demak and moved the capital city of Demak to the Prujang region. This transfer of the capital city became the starting point for the collapse of the Demak kingdom. Jiri Sunrise. Kerjunanajiri or Jiri Kadaten is an Islamic kingdom located in Gresik, East Java, led by rulers with the title of Susapunan in the 15th to 17th centuries, after Jiri was conquered by the Mataram Sultanate in 1636. The ruler of Jiri has the title Pinambuhan. Chunan, who held positions at Jiri, among others, Chunajiri from 1481 to 1506, Chunadalam from 1506 to 1546, Shuna Sevating Marji from 1546 to 1548. Shuna Kripin from 1548 to 6 Kablin Yamat Kingdom. The Kingdom of Kablin Yamat, also known as the Kingdom of Jetpura, was a Japanese kingdom in the 16th century based in Jetpura. Both Kablin Yamat and Jetpura were originally two separate duchies that were subject to the Kingdom of Demak. After the death of Prince Trungpa, Kablin Yamat got Jetpura, Pati, Juwana and Rambak. The peak of its glory occurred in the mid-16th century when Kablin Yamat was led by Queen Kablin Yamat. In 1551 and 1574, Kablin Yamat undertook expeditions to Portuguese Malacca to expel Portugal from the East Indies while extending its control beyond Java, such as West Kalimantan and Bataan Island. Kablin Yamat kingdom rulers include Queen Kablin Yamat from 1527 to 1536, Sultan Habibullah from 1536 to 1549, Prince Era the Jetpura from 1579 to 1599. In 1599, Mataram managed to conquer Kablin Yamat with an invasion that destroyed the city of Jetpura, both physically, politically and economically. Pojang Sultanate. The Kingdom of Pojang is one of the Islamic kingdoms on the island of Java. The kingdom located in the Kartasura area, Surakarta, Central Java, which is a continuation of the Kingdom of Demak. The Kingdom of Pojang was founded by Jaka Tingkir or Maskarabet in 1568. Jaka Tingkir was later given the title Sultan Habibullahia. The starting point for the founding of the Pojang Kingdom came from Peting village on the slopes of Mount Merapi. Jaka Tingkir is the son-in-law of Sultan Trungpa, who was given power in Pojang as a duke. Pojang was originally a subordinate area of the Demak Kingdom. When the Demak Kingdom collapsed, Jaka Tingkir got rid of its king Erupinang Sang and moved the center of government from Demak to Pojang. Under Sultan Habibullahia, Pojang experienced a golden age. He expanded his power eastward to Mataan. The Sultanate of Pojang has jurisdictions such as Pojang, Mataan, Mataram, Pati, Prada Demak, Kali Niama, Jetpura and Jipang Biojo Nagaro. Pojang is known to have a large rice barn because it has a good irrigation system. In 1581, Habibullah received recognition as an Islamic Sultan from important kings in eastern Java. After the war, Sultan Habibullah fell ill and died. His son Prince Benawan and son-in-law Birapad and Jiri are vying for the throne. Birapad and Jiri succeeded in becoming king in 1583 while Prince Benawan was eliminated to Jipang. In 1586, Prince Benawan allied with Sutawijaya of Mataram, who was also Habibullah's adopted son, attacked Pojang. This alliance succeeded in conquering Birapad and Jiri. Prince Benawan then became the third king of Pojang. Unfortunately, his reign only lasted a year. Because there was no one to replace him, Pojang was then given to Sutawijaya as a subordinate area of Mataram. The kings who ruled in the kingdom of Pojang, Adiwijaya or Jaka Tingkir from 1560 to 1582, Adipura or Irapanjiri from 1583 to 1586, Prabuwijaya or Prince Benawan from 1586 to 1587. Mataram Sultanate. The Islamic Mataram Kingdom was founded by Panambahan Senapati or Danong Sutawijaya at the end of the 16th century. The center of this royal government was around Yogyakarta, and had also been moved to Surakarta. Established during the Dutch colonial period, the Islamic Mataram Kingdom did not escape Bach interference. Danong Sutawijaya is the son of Ki Ajeg Bamane Ajin, who was entrusted by the king of the kingdom of Pojang Sultan Habibullahia to lead the Mentaboak forest area. Sutawijaya gave the name of the Mentaboak forest area to Mataram, and he received the title Panambahan Senopati. Panambahan Senopati or Sutawijaya then made Pojang a vassal state of Mataram. Since then, the Mataram kingdom was officially established. The Mataram Kingdom was officially established around 1586 and led by Panambahan Senapati. Here are the kings of Mataram Islam: Panambahan Senapati from 1586 to 1601, Daniel Krawatir Shuna Nyakrawati from 1601 to 1613, and Yakrakusuma or Sultan Ogun from 1613 to 1645, Amankurat 1 Ershuna Tekel Aram from 1646 to 1677, Amankurat 2 Ershuna Handel from 1677 to 1703, Amankurat 3 Ershuna Nas from 1703 to 1705, Pakubulwana 1 Ershuna Angelica from 1704 to 1719, Amankurat 4 Ershuna Joy from 1719 to 1726, Pakubulwana 2 Ershuna Kumbold from 1726 to 1742, was the son of Amankurat 4. Amankurat 5 Ershuna Dunning from 1742 to 1743. Succession between Pakubulwana 3 Prince Mankubuni and Prince Sagarnilat resulted in the Jayanti Agreement and the Salatiba Agreement. Then Mataram was divided into three powers: Surakarta-Hadiningrat Sunanat. The following are the rulers of the Surakarta-Hadiningrat Kasunanan: Pakubulwana II or Radan Mas Prabhusuilat from 1745 to 1749 was the son of Amankurat IV. Pakubulwana III or Radan Mas Suryadi from 1749 to 1788 was the son of Pakubulwana II. Pakubulwana IV or Radan Mas Subulbian from 1788 to 1820 was the son of Pakubulwana III. Pakubulwana 5 or Radan Mas Sugandhi from 1820 to 1823 was the son of Pakubulwana 4. Pakubulwana 6 or Radan Mas Satpradhan from 1823 to 1830 was the son of Pakubulwana 5. Pakubulwana 7 or Radan Mas Malikis Silikan from 1830 to 1858 was the son of 4 Pakubulwana. Pakubulwana 8 or Radan Mas Kusan from 1858 to 1960 was the son of Pakubulwana 4. Pakubulwana 9 or Radan Mas Duxana from 1860 to 1893 was the son of Pakubulwana 6. Pakubulwana 10 or Radan Mas Sayyid Malikal Krishna from 1893 to 1939 was the son of Pakubulwana 9. Pakubulwana's reign coincided with world events, namely Alexander Fleming discovering penicillin as the first antibiotic in 1928, which proved effective against many deadly bacterial infections. Then Pakubulwana 11 or Radan Mas Antaksin from 1939 to 1945 was the son of 10 Pakubulwana. Pakubulwana 12 or Radan Mas Suryodhiratno from 1945 to 2004 was the son of Pakubulwana 11. Pakubulwana 13 or Radan Mas Suryodhiratno in 2004 until now is the son of Pakubulwana 12, the Ngadi Ogyakarta-Hadiningrat Sultanate. Following that are the rulers of the Ngadi Ogyakarta-Hadiningrat Sultanate: Hamach Kubulwana 1 or Radan Mas Sujana from 1755 to 1792 was the son of Amankurat 4. Hamach Kubulwana 2 or Radan Mas Sundara from 1792 to 1810 was the son of Hamach Kubulwana 1. Hamach Kubulwana 3 or Radan Mas Suraja from 1810 to 1811 was the son of Hamach Kubulwana 2. Hamach Kubulwana 4 or Radan Mas Ignuyarat from 1814 to 1822 was the son of Hamach Kubulwana 3. Hamach Kubulwana 5 or Radan Mas Gado Manal from 1821 to 1855 was the son of Hamach Kubulwana 4. Hamach Kubulwana 6 or Radan Mas Mustaja from 1855 to 1877 was the younger brother of Hamach Kubulwana 5. Hamach Kubulwana 7 or Radan Mas Murja from 1877 to 1921 was the son of Hamach Kubulwana 6. Hamach Kubulwana 8 or Radan Mas Sutjati from 1921 to 1939 was the son of Hamach Kubulwana 7. Hamach Kubulwana 9 or Radan Mas Orajadian from 1939 to 1988 was the son of Hamach Kubulwana 8. Hamach Kubulwana's reign coincided with world events, namely World War II in 1939 to 1945. World War II had changed the face of the earth forever, causing the end of the era of European empires, creating the United Nations, and starting the Cold War. Then came Kubulwana 10 or Radan Mas Harjuna Darkato in 1988 until now is the son of Hamach Kubulwana 9. Mankuni the Rant Duchy. following that are the rulers of the Mancunegh Rand Duchy, Mancunegh I or Radon Mass, said from 1757 to 1795 was the grandson of a Moncure at Four. Mancunegh II or Radon Mass Sulama from 1795 to 1835 was the grandson of the son of Mancunegh I. Mancunegh III or Radon Mass S.A. Ranga from 1835 to 1853 was the grandson of the daughter of Mancunegh II. Mancunegh IV or Radon Mass Sudura from 1853 to 1881 was the grandson of the daughter of Mancunegh II. Mancunegh V or Radon Mass Sunita from 1881 to 1896 was the son of Mancunegh IV. Mancunegh VI or Radon Mass Suyutna in 1896 to 1916 was the brother of Mancunegh V. Mancunegh VII or Radon Mass Sir Joe Superta from 1916 to 1944 was the son of Mancunegh V. Mancunegh VIII or Radon Mass Hamidi Hodhosa Aroso from 1944 to 1987 was the son of Mancunegh VII. Mancunegh IX or Radon Mass Sujiwong Kulsuma from 1987 to 2021 is the son of Mancunegh VIII. Mancunegh X or Gusti Prince Hario Bibari Kakrakudamawira Sujiwong in 2022 until now is the son of Mancunegh IX. Pakualaman Duchy. Following that are the rulers of the Pakualaman Duchy. Pakualam I or Prince Natakusuma from 1813 to 1829 was the son of Hamish Kugulwana I. Pakualam II or Radon Tumengud Natadinangrad from 1829 to 1858 was the son of Pakualam I. Pakualam III or Prince Sasaraningrat from 1858 to 1864 was the son of Pakualam II. Pakualam IV or Radon Mass Nuthaningrat from 1864 to 1878 was a nephew of Pakualam III. Pakualam V or Prince Suryapilava from 1878 to 1900 was the son of Pakualam II. Pakualam VI or Prince Natakusuma from 1900 to 1902 was the son of Pakualam V. Pakualaman Trusteeship Council from 1902 to 1906. Pakualam VII or Radon Mass Hario Sudarjo from 1906 to 1937 was the son of Pakualam VI. Pakualam VIII or Radon Mass Hario Sutlarso Kanto Suratno from 1937 to 1998 was the son of Pakualam VII. Pakualam IX or Radon Mass Hario Amber Kusuma from 1998 to 2015 children from Pakualam VIII. Pakualam X or Radon Mass Wajovno Hario Bimo in 2016 until now is the son of Pakualam IX. Thus the description of the rulers of the land of Javat from the 6th century until now. I hope this is useful.